Hello everyone, it's me again, Yvonne Wood, married celebrant. Now, I have to tell you, I've just done a bridal expo at the Melbourne Convention and Exhibition Centre. It was the Melbourne Wedding and Bride Expo, and it was Friday night, Saturday and Sunday, an absolute blast. We had a great time. But I wanted to talk to you about some of the strengths and pitfalls of going to a bridal expo. At this one, we had lots of brides. We had heaps of amazing suppliers. It was a really interesting mix of wedding suppliers, from the ones that you'd expect to be there, like venues and photographers and videographers and celebrants, of course. But there were lots of things like photo booths with dry ice. There were people helping you to lose weight for your wedding. There were quite a few tailors there, which I haven't seen at an expo before. We had dance studios, we had makeup artists, we had florists, we had burlesque entertainment, just everything you could think of. It was really quite inspiring, really. But as well as being inspiring, it was pretty overwhelming for a lot of the brides that came through. So my first piece of advice for you, if you're going to a big expo, is to have a plan. Make sure you work out which direction you're going to go in, and then go in that direction and keep your method consistent. So many of the couples and families and groups that I saw came down one aisle and then got to a certain point and were sort of staring into space thinking, oh, where do we go next? And I'm sure they missed out on lots of really good suppliers just because they didn't really have a plan of attack and stick to it. Now, some of the amazing suppliers that I had around me, I had a fabulous couple of girls to my left. That was Miss Bella Bridal. They're based in Boronia. They were awesome girls. And across from me, I had Hit the Floor Dance Studio. And there was a gorgeous girl, Lauren, who was their representative on the day. And we had a lovely time, just even between the group of us, never mind all the beautiful brides and grooms that we got to see. So with your plan, like the word, some brides came on their own. When I said, how come you're doing this by yourself? They said, well, I just want to be able to concentrate. I don't want people telling me what to do and what not to do. I want to just be able to focus and see the people, the suppliers that I want to see, and make up my own mind. So that was an interesting plan. Others came, and this is more common, to come in a group, at least with one other person, if for no other reason than to carry the darn bags full of brochures, because that gets pretty heavy. And also just as a little bit of a sounding board, so that when you're going back that night and thinking about it, they're another person who has seen everyone that you've seen. You can remind each other. And probably the best thing about it is that you can have a bit of a laugh together, because you know it can be a long day, and it's great to have your mates or your mum or your mother-in-law or your best friend there to do it with. So then my advice is just to go home and reflect and recall what you've seen. Have a look through your brochures, because you tend to pick up brochures. People are so nice, they just take the brochures that people give them. So turf out the ones that you're not interested in, narrow it down to the suppliers that you are looking for and the ones that did appeal to you, and then just have a glass of wine and relax and enjoy the rest of the night. So the next thing is to wait for the barrage of emails that you will undoubtedly get in that first week after the expo. And don't be too hard on the suppliers. We all pay a lot of money to exhibit at those expos, and so following up on the leads is obviously one of the things that we have to do to make it worthwhile. So you'll get a lot of emails. Just wait for the ones that come from those suppliers that you've actually isolated as being the ones that you're interested in, and then act on those emails as soon as you can. Just bear in mind that the good suppliers go really quickly for the busy wedding months, February, March, and October, November. So we had a lot of brides at this expo getting married in October next year. So my advice to you is to get in quickly and don't dilly-dally so you don't miss out. I've already got about three double-ups for October, so it'll just be first in, best dressed for that one. So that's about it. If you'd like any more information about getting sorted for a bridal expo, please just jump over onto my website, www.yvonnewood.com.au. That's Yvonne, Y-V-O-N-N-E-W-O-O-D. And yeah, there's a contact form there. Shoot me through an email and I'll just have a chat and we can, I might be able to help you out with some other hints and tips for an expo. And yeah, I hope to hear from, I've already heard from some of my brides, some of my contacts, and looking forward to a barrage of emails back to me this week. Okay, bye for now. I'll talk to you soon.